Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing a very similar picker card to the 18 plus one I did a few months back. This is going to be when and how will you meet your soulmate, but not the 18 plus version. So any of you can watch this reading at any age. So let's get started with your reading. So we have group number one, group two, group three, and group four. So please choose your group now and let's get started with your reading. Timestamps are down below and in the comment section and in the description box down below. If you'd like some extra time, please pause the video. So let's get started with your reading. So starting off with group number one. Hello, group number one. So let's get started with your reading. So this is gonna be when and how will you meet your soulmate? So I have two oracle cards. Most of the cards I'm gonna shuffle as we go along. So we have the card of Hiddenite, and then we also have, oh, I love this card, how pretty. It says play, have fun, celebrate, don't be so serious. I love that. So we have Hiddenite. It says French existentialist, future trippers, bad romantics. It says when to use it: when you find yourself stuck in the past or too focused on the future. Hiddenite is down to make the most of every moment. If you're in a rut, call on Hiddenite to help you love your way out of it. Claim your happy place. So I feel the main message for you guys is to relax into the process of being single right now, or not knowing when your person is coming along. So when your soulmate comes along, it doesn't actually have to be a partnership, it could be a friendship as well. But for those of you who've chosen this reading, most of you are most likely going to be interested in a romantic partner. So I do feel as if it's basically telling you to have more fun in your life and not be so serious on the process, not be so serious that maybe you haven't got anyone yet, and that's okay. You know, have fun while the process is there, because you want to know what is fun for you, what fills you with a lot of joy. Because at the end of the day, somebody coming in isn't going to make you the most happiest, isn't going to fulfill like your entire life. You know, obviously it will take up a lot of your energy, but you have to know what makes you feel happy in the process. And also just playing and doing things lightly. And Hiddenite is a very nice energy of feeling in the present moment, being present, and it's a blue crystal here, so it's very much to do with the throat chakra and finding out what you love creatively. If you are feeling a little bit stuck on your life purpose right now, I do feel it's really important for you to find your path, to weave the web, like finding out what makes you, how you want to fulfill in this world, whether it's something that you really want to do like a hobby, or if there's a new kind of career venture you want to do. Just don't be scared of any new ventures, because I feel when you have the most fun and when you are not so serious, it's the best energy, because you're in a lighter vibration and therefore it's going to attract somebody who's also really fun, very natural, very authentic. Okay, so let's get some astrology and let's see what's happening for you guys within your astrological energy. Let's pick some dice. Okay, so we have the South Node, Virgo, and we have the Eighth House. So Virgo being the sixth house, most likely your North Node is going to be, let me think, North Node most likely be your 12th house, so would most likely be Pisces. So your North Node would most likely be Pisces. So I feel like for you guys, it is trusting your intuition is going to really, really help you manifest your person. Trusting the process. You may be a bit of a perfectionist as well. You may be somebody who needs to have everything perfectly aligned and have complete control. But we do have the eighth house here. So this is actually about intensity and endings and seriousness. I mean, Scorpio is very, very serious. So I do know, because I'm a Scorpio myself. So I do feel as if the eighth house is very much to do with your intimacy, how you're intimate with yourself. So I feel as if, have fun, you know, I mean, in the least wrong way of saying it, have fun with yourself, you know, like, and there's nothing wrong with that, by the way, guys. I just want to make it, you know, not 18 plus. Basically, just make your world all about you right now, because you have the time to. I feel when you meet your person, you're going to be in a really nice state financially, and I feel like you're going to be more organized and more established with your path. You're going to know where you're going, and you're not going to be so confused on your kind of situation. You're not going to feel rocky. I feel like you're going to feel much more settled within your energy. So we do have the number 8, so this could be about 8 months. I do feel you guys is quite a long time. When I say quite a long time, I mean more than a few weeks. I feel like it could be the 8th month, so it could be August that you meet somebody. It could be a Leo or a Virgo as well. But I do feel you're going to be very established when you meet your person. I don't mean you're going to be like fulfilled and content, it's going to be amazing. I just feel you're going to be in a much more stable place, okay? You're going to feel very stable within your energy and you're going to feel really good and like you have control over things. So I do feel like focusing on your love life, obviously this is about love, so I feel like focusing on what you love is most important, because when you meet somebody, if they ask you like, oh, what's the sort of things that you like, what are you interested in, if you're not too sure, it can be quite confusing to get to understand the other person, because if you can't share your whole authentic self, it's going to be a bit confusing. So I do feel getting to know yourself and understanding what your pleasures are, what makes you feel comfortable, you know, that sort of thing, that's going to help you to expand and to understand your path, okay? So it's essentially getting organized with yourself and preparing yourself for a relationship, really. So we have stellium, reinforcement and concentration. So I do feel like your life feels quite concentrated right now. It feels a bit intense. It feels a bit raw and rough. So I want to pull one more card. Actually, let's pull two more. Pisces and waning givers, releasing gratitude. Oops, I have a bit of a fluff on here. Nurture and acts of service. So I feel like the more you concentrate on your intuition and focusing on your spiritual path and nurturing yourself and others, I feel like this is a really nice energy here. So you could have your Venus in Aries for starters, but I do feel how you'll meet them is to do with releasing an old pathway. So I feel you're going to meet them through some sort of open opportunity. I think it's going to be to do with a new opportunity coming towards you, because I see that your career is expanding. And it's like you love your career so much that it's almost going to be like your kind of partnership before you are with someone physically. It's almost like the more you love your job, the more you love your life, you're going to attract that to you. So the more you release any kind of outdated beliefs around needing to be perfect in a relationship, needing to be this, you know, have everything under control and just be you, I feel like it's going to be a really nice way of kind of entering into this relationship. There's definitely an energy of expansion and enlightenment. So as you go through this process of arriving towards your person, you're going to be in a really nice place. And I feel like you can meet your person through your career and through your finances in some way. It feels like an enlightenment. It feels like you're going to meet your person through enlightenment as well. So it's almost like the more you discover more about yourself, the more you're going to manifest this relationship. And the more you discover what is your spiritual alignment, so what makes you feel spiritually aligned, the more you're going to recognize what you need. So essentially, how often do you want to meditate in the day? Do you want to meditate? Organizing your diet, and how you want to look after your body, recognizing how to nurture yourself is really, really important. And Pisces, as I say, I'm not sure fully 100% if it is the North Node, but I do feel if this is more about the North Node, it's about you choosing your own spiritual path, and most likely you're going to be doing a spiritual job when you meet your person. And a spiritual job can literally mean anything. It can mean teaching in a school. If it feels spiritual to you, then that could be that, you know. It could even be an office job if that feels spiritual to you, you know. So I feel like it's also maintaining your spiritual path, like keep aligning, keep grounding, going out in nature, talking to people who are on your wavelength, doing all those things to nurture your body and manifest the best version of you. That is going to manifest your person, and that is when your person is going to come in. Okay, so let's get you some tarot. Let's see what tarot you want. I'm gonna shuffle those again, and we're going to get a little bit more info. So where are you going to be when you meet your person? Cancer, first house, Venus, perfect. So this is a completely different energy. This is, I've chosen myself. I want a relationship, but I'm going to choose myself first. I'm going to nurture my body. I'm going to help my physical body to realign with my energetic body to do things that are on my wavelength and not because other people are doing it, you know, just doing my own thing and focusing on my own path and realigning myself from possibly being in education or being in a job that really wasn't good for me. Realigning, that's what I'm feeling. So you're going to be in a really nice place. And I do feel like you, I am hearing in a nice place in like in your home. So you could have moved house. I do feel also your home environment is going to change by the time you're with someone. So it could be it looks different because it's renovating, but I do feel you're going to be in a place where there's a lot of water. So you could be moving to more where there's waterfalls and oceans and things like that. But this meeting is going to be very fated. We do have the star, and that is all about patience, and it's about aligning with your purpose. And I do feel that the connection is going to be very fated. It's a fated connection. Then underneath the deck we have the Three of Rings, collaboration and competence. This is about collaboration with friendships. This is building friendships. So you're going to be having, I do feel like you could meet friends through your partner as well. I do feel you're going to have a very spiritual relationship. I do feel like you're going to meet someone very spiritual, and they're going to know what they want. So the more you know what you want, the more it's going to be, you're going to be in a really good space. And the Queen of Rings is all about the Queen of Pentacles. So I do feel you're going to be really good in your career. I feel like you're going to be very comfortable in your career. You're going to be in a career that just sustains you. I feel like it's going to raise your vibration because you're doing something that you really, really enjoy. So that is your reading, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. If you would like a private reading, please look down below in the description box. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Much love. Bye. Hello, group number two. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Let's get started with your reading. So I'm going to do some live shuffling in this video, but I'm going to start off with these oracle cards first. So we have the gorgeous amethyst cluster. I am obsessed with this crystal as well as this card. I think it's so beautiful. So we're going to have a look at that card in just a second. So the oracle card here says, inner temple, devotion, tune into the portal of your heart. And then let's have a look at the amethyst. So I do sell amethyst clusters on my store as well. They're really, really beautiful. They're so stunning, have a very high vibration. So if you're interested, link is down below. It just came to my mind, guys. I don't necessarily enjoy promoting myself, but if you guys are drawn to this amethyst and you want to find a place that sells them, I'm here for you, girl, okay? So amethyst, who needs it? Train wrecks who go off the rails on the wet and wild route to Bacchanalia. I think I pronounced that correctly. Any Pisces? Where to put it? The interior decorator's little purple secret. Amethyst can uplift the vibe of any living space. And then it also says when to use it, when it's time to give up the victim routine and start living with purpose. Hold on tight to amethyst. Get drunk on your higher self. So I feel like for you guys, you've been feeling very, very, very confused. So I feel like you guys are re-tuning into your past life. You could be going through past life things right now in your life that could have gone on in a past life. You're kind of reinventing yourself. I feel like you have really, really, really gone through the ringer with people. You've really gone through an energy of feeling very... I'm hearing the opposite of uplifted, and I'm really struggling my words today, guys. So I'm really sorry if I can't get my words out. You guys can help me in the comments if I can't think of a word. But I feel like you are going through, I'm hearing like a past life something, like you're going through, you may have gone through like a past life something. So where you go, basically go back into your past life and you can see what went on. I can't remember what the word is, but I feel like you're doing that, or you could have done that. So basically, I feel like you have done this for a long time. You possibly are in a victim mode right now. You're really struggling to assert yourself and be yourself and be authentic to your path. So I'm hearing, I feel very sorry for your energy right now. Like if you are really struggling, I'm putting my heart out to you. And I feel like you've been really struggling to just get grounded, get focused, and just really be yourself. I feel like a lot of people have treated you very badly in the past. And I think basically when it says to give up the victim routine and start living with purpose, this is you putting up your boundaries and self-loving yourself and giving yourself a really nice talk and being like, we can do this, girl. We can really put ourselves first. This is our time to really focus on ourselves. And this is the time for you to focus on yourself, because when you do, this is going to manifest your partner. And this is all about focusing on your heart chakra as well, and devoting yourself to things that you're really, really interested in and things that light your soul. So if you've been in a toxic, narcissistic relationship with anyone or anything, it could even be your own mind, you are working on releasing that now. So it could be quite an uncomfortable process. A lot of things like that can be and are. But you are getting there. You're climbing the ladder. You are getting there in baby steps. Okay, so don't force yourself. Don't struggle out of this. Just be in it right now. And sometimes things aren't happy-go-lucky all the time. But when we can come, when we do eventually come out of this energy, it can be, it feels so, oh my God, my words are so, it's so hard for me to talk right now. I think you guys could be struggling with this as well, like really struggling to get your words out. I feel like you guys are really alleviating, like things are alleviating out of your life. I hope that's the right word. Like things are coming out of your life and you're starting to feel much lighter, but you're also needing to readjust and realign your energy so you can manifest this energy, because you have definitely been in a possibly victim energy where somebody was very nasty to you or you were nasty to yourself. I feel like you're letting go of that now. And I do feel like you're almost having an interior decorator energy within your body. So you could be really having just like a 360 moment, like almost like a glow up energy where you're really just reinventing yourself. You could be dyeing your hair, having your hair in a different way. Your body, you could be, your body shape could be changing. You could be getting possible like surgery, or you could be working out and really getting your body in a nice toned way. I just feel like you are doing a 360, and this is the process to meeting your person. You are literally going through a gigantic transformation. So the more time you tune into yourself and your heart and what feels right for your intuition, that's going to lead you to where you're going. That is like the compass, your inner compass, okay? So let's have a look at the rest of your cards. So let's roll the dice and let's see, how is this person going to meet their person? Okay, so we have Sag, we have the third house, and we have Uranus. Okay, beautiful. Okay, so you're most likely going to meet your person through communication and establishing yourself. That is the main thing that I'm feeling. It feels like you're really knowing your worth, and most likely you're going to be quite well known in some sort of community. And it doesn't mean that you're like really famous or anything. I mean, maybe. But I feel as if you're just establishing yourself. So say if you've written a book, you're releasing it, and that's when you meet your person. It's like, or you could be starting a project and you begin that project and that's how you meet them. It could be somebody you're working with. It feels like travel as well. So it could be somebody who's abroad. You could be traveling abroad, obviously, when we're able to do so. And I feel as if there's some really deep regeneration going on. And I'm seeing a regeneration. I don't know if any of you guys have watched Doctor Who, you know what I'm talking about. Basically, those who haven't watched Doctor Who, there's a main character and he regenerates every time he needs to. And basically, he turns into this new person and everything about this person changes, but he's still the Doctor, he's still the main character. But the way he looks is completely different. So, and the way he acts in his personality, but he still is the Doctor, that he is still that character. So essentially your personality is going to really change. And I think the way you take in knowledge is going to be very different. You may start to read more. You may start to enjoy poetry. You may be somebody who is just really interested in spirituality on a different level. You could be looking into conspiracy theories, things like that, aliens, galactic energies, that sort of thing. You could be recognizing yourself as a starseed, all those lovely things. So that's what I'm feeling. It's kind of like you have this sort of epiphany, but you're regenerating. So it's not even transformation, but it feels more like a soul, like molecular level, like your molecules are almost changing. So really deep process. You're not going to recognize yourself when you come out of this. I feel like your mental health is really changing as well. You're becoming much more stronger within your mental body. So Sag, perfect. We have that right here. So we have Sag with the, what is that house? That is the ninth house. Ninth house, Kazemi in the heart. So this is all about your heart chakra. So you could be working on your heart chakra right now and yeah, just really work on your heart chakra, deep transformation with Scorpio. Perfect. I love that. And then we have sextile, which is all about cooperation, harmony, empathy. So after this, you're going to be more empathic. You're going to have more empathy for yourself. And I feel like you're just going to allow yourself to feel more and be more and just expand. And I feel like you're going to accept that job offer that you've been wanting, or that offer that is coming towards you. You're going to start accepting more offers, and you're going to start to be more assertive in your power. I feel like when you're going to meet your person is, I don't feel like there's a timing for you guys, so I do apologize for that, but I am hearing number 7 and number 8 and 9. So that could be in months. And I do feel like for some of you guys, it could be 1 year to 1 year 6 months, because I feel like you guys are really going through a really generous process. So it's going to take quite a lot of your energy. So you need to be single for now, so you can be with someone after you've gone through this really big process. And we do have the South Node. This is you releasing everything that you're coming away from that you've possibly held in past lives, and it's no longer needing to be there anymore. It's a lesson that you've learned, and it's no longer needing to be there anymore. So it's something that you have really worked on. And with the Sag, it says, this is the house of long distance travels, foreign languages, inspiration, optimism, publications, higher education, spirituality, philosophy, religion, ideals, morals, and ethics. Wow, that's a lot. So literally you guys are going through like a really gigantic process of the way you think. And I feel like you're looking more outwardly rather than inwardly, which is also good. You are doing a lot of inward processing, but I feel like you're more concentrated on the world and how to help it and you're also focusing on nature as well. Like you're really being very present with your heart. And because if you are working on your heart chakra, which I do see that you are, this is going to affect the way you see nature. So you're probably going to be really connected to nature as well. I feel like for you guys, I'm not getting drawn to a certain place as to how you're meeting your person. It's literally a mystery, very scorpionic energy. So I feel like you're literally not meant to know, but I do see you getting married to this person with those two of rings. That's the two of pentacles right there. So you're going to be balancing out your career and your money and your love life. You might actually be in an energy of like, I don't really want anyone right now. Or when you actually get, you might actually really, really want someone right now, but when you get to this person, you might think, oh, I'm not too sure. And that's actually a really good place to be, because essentially when you meet somebody, most of the time, if they are your kindred spirit, not a soulmate, like your literal kindred spirit, like you don't have any karma with them, most of the time you're not actually, you know, that excited when you meet them, because you don't have that intense karmic tie to them. So that's actually going to be a really nice energy, and you're going to get to know them very gently. And we have the Four of Cups, contemplation, reevaluation. This is literally you and what your energy is going to be like when you meet them. You're going to be like, I'm not too sure, you know, but actually this person's going to be so good for you. They're not going to take no for an answer, and they're going to be really generous with you. Like they're going to be very generous with your time. They're going to be very patient with you, and you're going to be really concentrated on your work when you meet them. You're going to be concentrated on your passions and what you love and your life purpose. And we do have the Fool in the reverse. So right now you might be feeling really unmotivated or not very optimistic. But when you do meet your person and you start focusing more on your journey, or as you are focusing on your journey, your optimism will start to rise, and you're going to start to feel like you can just be, you know, by yourself right now. But this is, and then the Fool is a new beginning. So when you start to kind of open yourself up to new opportunities, or opportunities begin to come towards you naturally, I do feel they will, this is going to be a brand new start. I do feel like, okay, travel is going to be a really big thing for you guys. I'm really picking up on that. Like there's going to be somebody who, you're like the travelers of the groups, I feel like. You are somebody who will literally pack up your bags and go the next day. That's what I'm picking up on. Or you literally will pack up your bags. If someone gave you a plane ticket, I feel like you would literally take it and go. I feel like a lot of you guys are air signs and earth signs. You're very gentle with your energy and sometimes a little bit scattered, but you are going to manifest somebody who's very, very grounded and also someone really, really fun as well. That's what I'm picking up on. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you'd like a private reading, all my information's down below. I am hearing, I highly recommend a past life reading. I don't know if I said about past lives in this group, but I am really being drawn to past life, and I do offer a past life reading. So if you're interested in the way you work or past relationships, things like that from your past life, and how it's affecting you right now, I highly recommend that particular reading. That's just what I thought of in the moment. And also I'm hearing clear quartz. That'll be really, really good for you. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Also, we have 11:11 on the timing. Much love. Bye. Hello, group number three. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Let's get started with your reading about when and how will you meet your soulmate. So soulmates can be romantic as well as friendship. So just take it as it resonates, but most likely it will be romantic. So those of you who are single or you're wanting a man or a woman or anyone, this is for you. So let's go. So I'm going to be doing some life shuffling as well. We're going to start off with these two cards first. So this is the celestite crystal. I absolutely freaking love celestite along with larimar. They're both extremely gorgeous crystals. This is really beautiful. Highly recommend this to you guys. Very, very peaceful, very open. I feel like I'm hearing just cracking you open, like this geode. On the outside, it's like it is a rock. I mean, all crystals are rocks essentially, but this geode on the outside, it looks like a stone. It looks like an ordinary rock, and then you crack it open and it's this gorgeous crystalline energy inside. It's like, holy crap, it's like a little cave. So I feel like for you, you are being cracked open right now, and everything that you've worked on, all the parts of you that are natural to you, are literally being shown to you right now, and they're being expressed. And I feel like you're really expressing yourself, which is so gorgeous, and your throat chakra is really on point. Also, if you're struggling with your throat chakra, like coughing a lot and things like that, I would highly recommend this crystal and also blue lace agate. So celestite, and let's have a look at this card as well. Sorry guys, my brain is like everywhere right now. So share your voice, literally, as I said, throat chakra. Oh my god, and it says cave. Oh my god, that's so great. Oh, thank you universe, I love you, bless you. Come out of the cave, persecution, expression. Oh my god, that's literally everything I just said. Thank you universe, I love you. Okay, anyway, sorry guys, I'm getting excited. Okay, I feel I need to read this whole thing, so let's do that. So what is it? Blue gray celestite is a delicate sulfate. Guys, this is so funny. I hope you're enjoying this reading because this is a friggin' mess. Okay, celestite, blue gray celestite is a delicate sulfate, not malfate, mineral with airy, buoyant blue cotton candy vibes. It gets its name from the Latin word for heaven. And if you close your eyes and ask nicely, maybe it will take you there. Who needs it? Anyone brazenly ignoring the consistent inner voice that actually has some good ideas for how you might better handle this whole life thing. Where to put it? As a calming adornment wherever you meditate or pray. When to use it? When it's time to stop and really listen. With celestite as a guide, you might be surprised what you hear. Tune into your serenity. And then as this card says, come out of your cave, persecution, expression. So I'm actually going to look up the word persecution because I feel like it's a really intense word and I'm getting very, very drawn to this particular word. So it says, okay, persecution is the act of harassing or oppressing a person or a group of people, especially because of their identity. Okay, so I feel as if this is you being hard on yourself. I feel like a lot of people have put you down, have told you you're not good enough, you're too this, you're too that, blah, 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 blah. It's all noise, essentially. It's all about what they, and essentially when people say this to you, it's more about them than about you. Somebody says, oh, you're so ugly or whatever. You are not girl, okay? That is just them. People who are hurting hurt other people, okay, girl? You know, we don't want to be in that energy no more. So I feel like you are somebody who is very, very intuitive, have a very delicate energy, and you're somebody who's most likely not, you don't feel like you are like a lot of people. You're always feeling possibly quite lonely or just isolated. You feel like you can't really connect with a lot of people, and you're somebody who sees like the bigger picture where a lot of people see more of like the smaller picture of the people who you've been around, I feel. So I feel like the person you're becoming is you're just accepting yourself for who you are and what your beliefs are, and accepting, you're naturally accepting, I feel like, of other people's beliefs, but other people haven't been accepting of your beliefs. So now it's time for you to really shine, and I feel like you're going to meet somebody kind of on the other side of this pyramid. And what this basically means is the more you embrace your intergalactic, gorgeous, earth angel, star seedy vibes, and really just go into your entire personality, like full on go for it, girl. Like, don't stop yourself from being interested in something just because it makes somebody uncomfortable, just because it doesn't vibe with them. This is your time. This is your time on earth. use it for your energy. Do what you love, you know, do what really awakes you and makes you feel good. It isn't about anyone else. This is about you, okay? And when you meet your person, they're also on a very similar journey. So the more you concentrate on things that really light you up and you're fascinated by, why the hell would you want to stop yourself from being interested in something as well? You know, why would you want to stop yourself? Because at the end of the day, you're born this way for a reason. You know, I'm also hearing that song Born This Way by Lady Gaga, that really like strong beat. I love that. So I feel like for you, you have been in a cave for quite a long time. And this doesn't have to mean that, you know, you've done absolutely nothing. Essentially, you've been doing the most. I feel like you've been really inward. You've really been gathering a lot of knowledge and information. Now it's time for you to share it. Now it's time for you to get out there and friggin' use it, you know. Be open, take up space, you know, ask somebody out on a date, go on a dating site, go somewhere you've never been before, eat something different, you know, whatever feels right for you, friggin' do it and do something that's different for a change. I'm hearing just spice up your life, girl. I'm getting a lot of songs, so you're probably somebody who really likes music, and I'm hearing Spice Up Your Life by the Spice Girls. I feel like also you guys need to meditate really badly, okay? So this is an energy of basically tuning into your energy. You need to take a break, okay? You do so much for everyone else. You always think about other people. It's time to think about yourself, but also going into the cave. You know, it says come out of the cave, but actually this might mean that you need to go in your cave. You might need to recuperate and rest for a while and just be in your own energy. Maybe take some time off work, you know, and just tune into yourself and what do you need to do right now to help your own body, because you can't help other people if you're not helping yourself, essentially. And I feel they need to pull you a Angels of Atlantis card. I just feel really drawn to do that. I feel like there's a guide that's really helping you. So let me have a look and see. I didn't do this for any other group, but I feel they need to do it for you guys. So let me pull you one of these cards. I'm hearing Uriel, so I wouldn't be surprised if Uriel popped his little head out. Oh, Raphael. Okay, Earth Force. Oh, lovely. Let's get one more. Another Raphael card. Cleansing. Beautiful. A lot of water in this group. We have lots of blue here, and we have blue here and water here. There's definitely energy of like accepting yourself for this beautiful starseedy person that you are. If you're into crop circles, friggin' be interested in them, girl. Like, don't stop yourself just because somebody can't handle your energy, because at the end of the day, if someone can't handle their energy, a lot of the time that's more about them than it is about you, you know. And you got to be yourself, you know. If you're intense, be intense. If you have a big aura, friggin' shine it, you know. But obviously protect yourself, girl, because sometimes if you do have a big aura, you do need to make sure you're protecting that energy as well, because that can also harm you if you're stretching it too far. So we also have Grace. This is Gabriel. So this is you just soaring and being yourself, being authentic and being who you naturally are, and just really sharing your voice, you know. And also, you are forced to be reckoned with. You have a very big purpose on this earth plane, and you're being prepared for that with your partner. So your partner's got a really big life purpose as well. So you're both going to be these cute little beings. When you come together, it's going to be like explosion. I'm hearing the song Explosion as well by Ellie Goulding. Is it Explosion? That's what I'm hearing. I'm hearing a lot of light and a lot of earth. So a lot of you guys could be star seeds. A lot of you guys could be earth angels. Really high vibe energy from this group. Okay, so let's get some more information. Let's have a look and see what's going on. So how will they meet their person? Thank you. I'm seeing you guys at tennis. Tennis? Okay, so is it actually physically tennis? Yes. So you might actually meet them in a gym where there's tennis, or outside where there's tennis. It might literally be in like a public tennis place, because I know there's like, you can get those. In a park. You could be with your children and they're with their children and they're in a park. Or you could literally be just, you know, chilling in the park. There's another one as well, something else. What's the other thing? It could be running and you meet another runner. Could be a dancer, meet another dancer. It's like there's something physical about your body as well. So I feel like you could be meeting a Scorpio. This person has a very high, let's say, intimacy drive, okay? Trying to avoid the word right now. Intimacy, they're very high intimacy, okay? You possibly have quite a high intimacy level as well. You've really been working on your relationships and grounding them into place. You have really been working on your career as well. And you're also still working really hard on your career right now to get it to a place where you're very happy. But you are very career driven right now. You could, might not be, that might not be part of your personality, but for those of you who it is, you are very career driven, but also you are just very concentrated on your career right now. Okay. So how you'll meet them is when you are more established or just feeling established in your career. You will most likely meet someone who is famous if you are famous. Essentially, you will be on the same path, so your person will be very much like you. So if I'm describing somebody and it sounds like you, girl, that is a good sign. Like, I have seen so many comments of you guys saying, this person sounds like me, I don't want somebody who's like me. And I'm like, girl, that's good. You know, because that means that that person is for you. So basically, this person is very intense. You guys and this person could have been through really, really intense retrogrades, lots of reoccurring energy, and you're just like, please stop, universe, please stop. So Mars, we have Mars and we have Aries, so that's perfect. So you guys are very career driven. This person's very career driven, could be meeting an Aries. Right now, you are feeling like you're paused. Your love life is very much paused, because you are in limbo. You're changing your plan, your chat. Your plans are changing because you are focused on your destiny. This person is part of your destiny. You guys are quite relationship orientated as well. You're somebody who really loves connections and relationships and people. You really love connecting with people. So I do feel like you could be highly, highly communicating with somebody through online, or this person will come up and talk to you randomly, because I feel like this person's really confident with their speech, and when they see something they want, they really, really want it. So this is the third house of Gemini. This is communication, thoughts. It also says, and the capacity to relate to the most immediate and daily social environment, like siblings or neighbors. So this person could even be a neighbor. You know, it could be like, I'm hearing Stacey's mum. I know that sounds really random, but I'm hearing the song Stacey's Mum, and it's kind of like, you may know somebody, not anything to do with Stacey's mum. It's literally like, just, you may know somebody who you really fancy and you're like, damn, that person's really, really attractive. But you may not have the courage to go towards them. So they may actually, I'm hearing, retrieve the favor and basically like flip the favor, and basically they are going to come towards you. But it feels like you've gone through such an intense time. You can meet this person on the 10th month, 10th day. Also, this is about completion. So basically you're completing a cycle right now. I feel like at the start of the year as well. So obviously this is a timeless reading, but I do feel like for you, okay. So basically if you guys have already gone past, you know, January 2021, this is going to be around the time when things start to feel clearer. Your body feels clearer. Your mind feels clearer. You feel like the best in the best place, I feel. Because basically with the North Node, you're not going to be in a place of confusion. I feel like you're going to be really focused on your North Node, and you're going to be focused on your life path. So you're going to be very concentrated on something, and it's going to feel really, really easy. Like this part, not so much. This doesn't feel easy here. It's like you have to get yourself out of like a confusing situation. But when you do, there's going to be a nice little transition, nice little pause, and then boom, there they are. Okay. So I feel like this person's like super confident. They could be an Aries as well as Scorpio. I'm getting air signs. I'm picking up on pretty much every sign. I'm picking up if they are an earth sign, they could be a Taurus. Okay. But every other sign I'm picking up on as well. No. There we go. Okay. So we have the Hermit. That is what you're doing right now. You're pausing in time. Which is perfect. You're going in your little cave and you're like, I'm good, I'm good. I'm good. And not really, but I'm feeling it's okay. You know, like I'm struggling, but it's okay. That's basically what you're doing. You're literally needing to just nurture yourself. Okay, so here we go. You are struggling with your mental health, possibly have been struggling with your mental health. You are now coming out of that, or coming out of that very soon, because you've worked on yourself, you've gone inwards. It's now time for you to have a relationship. I feel as if this person has so many different aspects to them. It's unreal. They're kind of a complicated person, but a beautiful person. Okay, they've got many, many facets. And you may be an intense person as well. So you're both going to come together really nicely. You both have extremely intense views. There's a card here. Here we go. Profound change. That's exactly what I'm feeling. You guys are literally going to go through the most gigantic transformation. We have the Page of Swords. I'm pretty sure this is the Page of Swords. Eagerness and tenacity. So it's like you're finding your purpose, like right there. You're like, okay, I've finally found it. Boom. Then you meet your person. So most likely you and your person are going to be very, very similar, and you're going to have the same likes and dislikes. Very, very similar. You're both going to be extremely ambitious and a massive new start when you come out of this change. I feel I need to pull so many cards for you guys, but I feel like this makes so much sense. because you're going to be like this new changed person. Okay, you're most likely going to be really drawn to amethyst as well, because amethyst is a really beautiful crystal of change and intuition. Your intuition is going to really be vibing with this person. You're most likely going to meet this person, you're going to be like, oh, that's who they are. Like, I've seen you in my dreams, or I've seen you in meditation, you know, that kind of thing. My camera's going really out of whack now, I'm talking about intuition. So that is your reading, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for being here. If you'd like a private reading, all my information is down below. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, group number 4. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. I'm going to be live shuffling some cards in just a second, but we're going to focus on these first. So, first we have Lemurian Quartz. We then have Take a Break, A Life's Work, Not a Season, Get Off the Treadmill. And then we also have Mintaken, Longing for Home, Belonging, The Original Lightworkers. So, let's have a look at this card first. So, it says, Lemurian Quartz, anyone in need of a vacation from their thoughts? It says, when to use it, whenever someone or someone you love needs a zap of healing, energy, awaken your inner wizard or witch and cast a spell with Lemurian Quartz, escape your mind. So kind of like my little selenite wand, just go wee around their energy or around your energy and just have a nice cleanse. So first of all, you guys have been going through it, okay? You have really been going through this. I feel like mentally, physically, and just in your life, you've been going through a lot. Now is the time to take a break, okay? Really time to meditate, time to get, I mean, it says get off the treadmill, but I feel like it's time to get on the treadmill, and so literally on a treadmill, like move your body, shake your body up, go for a walk, go outside. And I feel like for you guys, you are definitely longing for connections. You're longing for somebody who really understands you and who gets you on every level. I feel like you have, I'm hearing actually you may have been bullied in this life or in a past life. And it's really knocked your confidence. I feel like you may even bully yourself a little bit. So I am sending my love out to you. I do feel as if it's really time for you to go inwards and to ask yourself, what do I need right now? And keep asking yourself that when you feel confused. And if you don't know, just take a break. You know, just literally take 5 minutes, take 10 minutes, take a day, a week to just focus on you and refueling your energy. I'm hearing you can't drive on empty, basically. It's literally, it feels like you're driving on empty. I'm hearing like dryness. I'm feeling dry. It feels like my body feels like a Sahara desert right now as I'm talking. It feels dry. I feel like I need to like moisturize my energy, which sounds very strange, but yeah, it feels like I need to cleanse. So I feel like it's time for you to release any old negative patterns, outdated beliefs, and this could be what you're doing right now. I feel like a nice foot massage would really help you. So if you don't like feet, maybe put some socks on. But like, look at the points on reflexology, possibly look up a reflexology map and just massage the points that feel really good for you. You can also get like a crystal like this with like a rounded end, and you can like basically push into the skin on your feet or on your body and just really moisturize and nurture that part of your body. Because when we massage the points on our feet, it actually goes and nurtures the other parts of our body. So like our heart, you can do the heart. You can, if you've got a bit of heart palpitations, if you've got a bit of neck pain, you can really focus on those points in the foot. Also, you can do this on the hands. It depends. Obviously, you do what feels right for you. But I do feel the need to kind of cleanse and drink a lot of water and just be in the moment right now, because I feel like you've overworked yourself or you've burnt the candle at both ends. I feel like also you're doing the best you can, guys. I feel like you're really hard on yourself. I feel like you're somebody who needs a lot of perfection a lot of the time, or needs something to be perfectly aligned to manifest, and it doesn't work like that. Basically, I mean, sometimes things are obviously perfectly aligned for our soul, but they don't always feel perfect on the earth plane. So you could be going for a deep transformation and then you meet your person, you know, that sort of thing. So that's what I'm feeling. It's like, I feel like the need for change, and I feel like more than any time now, change is so important. So if you can do a little bit of change in the day, do something that you really enjoy, even if it's something small, I feel that would really help shake up your energy a bit, because I feel like you're feeling very, your energy feels a little bit grey, I'm hearing. So kind of getting a little bit of vibrational energy can really help. So get your body moving, talk to a friend, get your mind, you know, moving. Okay, so let's have a look at how you meet your person. I'm going to do that again. Don't want to do that. No. Okay, they're saying back away. I'm like, okay. So we have Gemini to wealth house and we have Mercury. So you are literally going through the ending of a cycle. So I'm going to shuffle these again, but this is basically what you're going through right now. You are going to meet your person when you recognize your own personal power. Okay. And it doesn't have to be, it's a personal power, but also it actually comes through as a revelation. So you're going to have some sort of epiphany, and that then your energy shifts and then it attracts a new person in. That's what I'm hearing. I'm also hearing a change in your relationship with yourself and the way you relate to yourself. You could be going through like an actual transition with your body. So you could be going through like a dietary change, fitness. You could also be someone who is actually changing gender, you know, that sort of thing, like a really big change. It just feels like you're having this massive awakening, and it's like then you're getting ready for this new partner. That's why you're going through it, essentially. So can we see where you're going to be when you meet your person? Okay, Mercury again. Yep, I knew the seventh house was going to be there. That's why I said a relationship. So I feel as if you're going to be more open to a relationship when you meet your person. So I don't feel right now your energy is ready. I feel like when you meet your person, you're going to be ready. I'm hearing in about, okay, for the most part, for literally the most time, the maximum time, 3 years. This is for those of you who are not really concentrated on a relationship and have also gone through a breakup quite recently, or you are literally in quite an intense transformation, okay? For those of you who have been single for quite a long time, I feel as if it's going to be at the most a year. Okay, it could be also the next year. So if you are watching this in 2020, I'm seeing 2021. If it's 2021, 2022, you know, like a year ahead, basically, or within that year. And it could be earlier than that. I am seeing you meeting your person through career, through some sort of job. But I'm seeing your person is like, I'm hearing, okay, some of you, this person's a barista. You're literally going to meet them at a coffee shop. And somehow you're going to connect to them, basically, okay? And it's going to be really easy. This person's very gentle. They have a very Gemini energy, and Pisces and Sag. They're very optimistic. And there's somebody who could be from a foreign country. So they literally could have recently just traveled to the country you're at. Or they could not look like they're from the native country that they're in right now. Okay. So they could have parents who are possibly a different culture. So they look different to, say, like, you know, the stereotypical person of your country that you're in. So you could really be attracted to this person because they are really, I'm hearing they're very ethical. There's somebody who possibly is a vegan, a pescatarian, vegetarian, paleo, that sort of thing. They're very conscious of animals, conscious of their diet, conscious of change, and they love change. There's somebody who's very open to change. Their Mercury's like on point. They have a lot of knowledge. They could be a Sag. There's somebody who's very self-expressive. And I feel like because you're figuring out who you are, this person is going to know who they are when you meet them. So that's why you're focusing on yourself and knowing who you are, so you can really relate to this person. And this is really, really beautiful. This is somebody who just knows themselves. So we also have the eighth house. This is the house of Scorpio. This is Pluto. So this is the house of life's enigmas, transformation, the hidden, sexuality and death. Here is where we can see someone else's property, money, real estate, inheritance and investments. We can also see our deepest unrevealed wishes, as well as fears, occultism and esotericism. I transform. So you're going to be a completely different person. I feel like right now, I don't feel like you'd actually be attracted to this person, or you don't have the time for this relationship right now. I feel like you may think you have the time, but I don't feel like your energy is ready for it. This person's coming in very, very soon though. Like, they may even know this person quite soon in the next like 3, 5, 7 months. And then you get in a relationship after that time. So it's like you need to get to know this person first on a friendship level possibly. And that's when you meet them. They definitely have moved house though. They definitely aren't in their native country. There's somebody who's possibly traveled when they were quite young, or maybe in the last few years they traveled to the country you're in. But it feels like they are a foreigner. They do belong to that country. They could have even been born there. But they do feel like a foreigner. There's somebody who feels like, they could even be like a starseed. So they may not feel like they're of the earth, basically, as well as that. So on a, like a physical plane, but also on a spiritual one as well. And we also have conjunction. And this is about personal interests. So you are literally working on your personal interests. You're working on the way you relate to people and the way you see yourself. Okay. So that's really beautiful. So let's get you some tarot. Can you tell me about this person as well? I'm interested to see what it says about the person. Okay, so somebody, they're very stable, they're very invested, and there's somebody who's quick thinker. There's somebody very genuine, very loving, they're very family orientated as well. So they're saying to that I shuffle the dice, because basically these personality traits will help you identify who they are as well. Sorry guys. So we have the Nine of Wands, test of strength, perseverance. Exactly. You're going for a really big transformation. So it's testing your knowledge, your perseverance, your energy with yourself. And you may be speculating when this person comes in, because you think, oh, this is not the right person, but actually it is. And it begins a new cycle. And you're like, okay, wasn't expecting that. Literally a barista, like it can be so random. Like you could go into a coffee shop completely single and come out with this person's number, you know, like it's going to be so random. Okay, so it could be through a friendship as well. I do feel like you're going to be out with your friends when you meet them possibly. So as I say, it could be a coffee shop, a pub, that sort of thing. But I feel like you're going to be in a very happy energy. You're going to be feeling really content with your life. It might even be a day when you feel a bit down, but you are for the most part feeling very content about your life. You're feeling very happy and you're feeling very productive. I do feel like right now you are in a bit of a confusing state or a bit of a confusion energy, but this will change and shift as things move along, as time moves along, and as you focus on your endurance and your productivity and doing things productive and helping yourself with that. I do feel like concentrating on a project will really help this energy shift forward. Very Virgo, very organized. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this reading. If you would like a private reading, all my information is down below. I hope you have a lovely day. I love you guys so much, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye.